HDV records to mini DV tape, just like you're already used to using. However, the data that goes down to this tape is different than what you're used to using in the DV world. DV uses a non-temporal compression scheme where every frame is a frame. DV has a bitrate of approximately 25 megabits per second or 13 gigabytes per hour. So there are some differences. So where are the big differences? Well, first of all, in the HDV world, we're recording MPEG-2 data to the tape instead of the 411 DV compression that we're dealing with. MPEG-2 has a color compression or a color sampling ratio of 4:2:0. So again, this is different than the 411 of DV. Now, PAL-DV uses a color sampling scheme of 4:2:0 as well. However, it is somewhat different than what we're dealing with in the MPEG-2 HDV world. Some other differences are in the bit rates. If we're dealing with a 720p format of HDV, we're recording that information down at 19 megabits per second. If we're recording in the 1080i format, we're recording at a bit rate of 25 megabits per second. So we've got a little bit of difference in the bit rate. You'll notice that the 1080i format is the same bit rate as DV. What that means is 1 hour of DV equals approximately 13 gigabytes of storage. In the HDV world, 25 megabits per second also equals approximately 13 gigabytes of storage per hour. Now, another difference is how the information is recorded onto the tape in what's called a group of pictures, or what is often referred to as GOP. The group of pictures format comes in two flavors. In the 1080i version, we're dealing with a group of pictures where we have one iframe per every 15 frames of information. That means in a 1 second segment of video, we have a total of two iframes. That's two complete frames every second. The remaining frames are B frames and P frames. These are backward frames and forward predictive frames. So we're looking at vector frames that predict backward information and forward information to complete the frame information that we're looking at. In the 720p format, we have what's called a 6 GOP. We have one iframe every 6 frames in our image. So we have a few more iframes in the 720p format. Either way, you're going to want to keep in mind how the iframe structure and the B and P frame structure come into play when you start editing with HDV. A couple of other important factors to keep in mind when you're dealing with HDV versus DV is HDV has a significantly better error correction rate than DV has. In fact, HDV has the highest error correction rate of any video format currently in the industry today. Now let's look at how the I and B and P frames, or the intra frames, the backward predictive, and the predictive frames work inside the HDV world. Let's look at this graph that's in front of you here, and you can see that we've got in the first image a full car with a complete scene there. In the next frame, we look at what pixels are redundant. In other words, the grass hasn't changed, the houses haven't changed, the sky, the street, and the trees haven't changed, but the vehicle is moving through. So the vehicle is recorded as vector data. Now, the next coming frames, the B frames and P frames, we'll look at the preceding and post-seeding frames, and this is how they will draw or create the image that is going to be presented to the human eye. This type of compression has some significant benefits in that it allows us to put tremendous amounts of information down onto a relatively small amount of videotape or into a relatively small amount of storage space. So why was mini DV tape chosen in the first place for storage of HDV? A simple reason: cost. In other words, all of the infrastructure for manufacturing the tape transports, the tape shell housings, and the heads and the drums and all of the equipment was there already because it's a byproduct of the DV world. This means that we're able to deliver HDV camcorders at an extremely low cost. If it was that we had to develop, or if the manufacturers had to develop, new tape transport mechanisms and drums and heads and tape shells and tape media, the cost of these cameras would be roughly 3 times what they are. And that would take it out of the price range of most of us. Another one of the important differences between HDV and DV and even DV cam is that DV cam and DV operate across one single track for its error correction. In the HDV world, in the 1080i format, we have error correction that spans over 16 tracks. So in other words, we've got a lot of error correction information in those tracks. In the 720p format, we're operating across a total of 10 tracks. Now, in marketing speak, some manufacturers will tell you that one format is better than the other. This really isn't true because the 6GOP versus the 15GOP and the 16 tracks versus the 10 tracks tend to balance themselves out. So don't get caught up in marketing hype. Just understand that HDV has significantly better error correction than anything you've ever dealt with in the past. Let's have a word or two about color space. If you've been working in the DV world, you've been operating in a color space of 411. You can see on the chart here how the color is sampled in the DV world. On the other hand, in the HDV world, it's sampling at a color ratio of 420, and it gives us the opportunity for a much more robust color signal. You can see again on the chart here what this means. But in the real world, what does all this really mean? Well, it means a couple of great things. First of all, when you're recording in the HDV world and you're going to be delivering in the DVD world, there's no color space shift. In other words, we're staying in the same color area or in the same color sampling area for HDV as we are in the final DVD product. Why do you care? Well, let's take a little bit of a standard example. You go out and shoot something with your DV camcorder and you're shooting in the 411 color sampling ratio. You put that into your NLE and you edit in your NLE at 411. And you might even be creating titles that are 444. They're uncompressed titles in your final product. So what do? You render that entire DV stream down to a finished DV AVI, right? Well, then we're going to take that and drop that into our DVD encoder or our MPEG-2 encoder. We're starting with 411, we're going to 420. Well, the math doesn't quite work out. If you figure it out, what you end up with is a color signal of 410. So we've lost quite a bit of our color information on top of the already tremendously compressed DV signal. On the other hand, in the HDV world, we're shooting 420, we're editing 420, or we're editing 422, and we're delivering 420. So we haven't gone through any chroma shift or color sampling shift in the entire process of producing our DVD. This is just one of the main benefits of the 420 color sampling space for HDV.